Students, yesterday we discussed some named reactions. Okay, and today still some more important named reactions we are going to see in carboxylic acids. Okay, and its derivatives. Now, the next one is the Reformatsky reaction. Reformatsky reaction. Okay, so what is this Reformatsky reaction? It happens between whom? Now, here what happened? See clearly, CH2 Br, C double bonded O R. Okay, so this is one compound. Now, this is reacting with the carbonyl compound R1 C double bonded O OR2. Okay. In presence of zinc, then after acidic hydrolysis followed by heating, what is the product form? And that product formation I am going to show you with the help of the mechanism. First of all, what is the starting reactant here? Okay, that is important here. So starting reactant is alpha bromo ester. Alpha bromo ester. So you see, this is the ester functional group bonded carbon alpha. Further bromine is bonded. You see, so this is the alpha bromo ester. Alpha bromo ester is reacting with a carbonyl. Alpha bromo ester is reacting with a carbonyl. Maybe aldehyde, maybe ketone. Okay, in presence of zinc, first reagent, second one, hydrolysis followed by heating. Hello? Yes, ma'am. I didn't understand, ma'am, actually what you are telling. Where paper is available? Today question is completed, means today only they will release the paper, madam. In NTA website, in NTA website, Okay, I will see. Okay. Hello. So sorry for disturbance. So now, here, are you able to hear me, everyone? Please respond. Are you able to hear me? Okay, so we are going to see this mechanism now. See clearly, everyone know. So here, what is the product form that we are going to see along with the mechanism? Along with the mechanism, we are going to see that one. Followed, everyone. Now, what happened here in the mechanism part? First of all, CH2Br. Okay. Then that is COOR alpha bromo ester. Clear, everyone? So now here I am taking the zinc. As you know, zinc is giving zinc plus two electrons. Zinc is giving zinc plus two electrons. Followed. So now what happened? Bromine is very good leaving group. It departs out. Okay. Now this carbon get the positive charge. One positive charge on that one positive. Two negatives are attacking on that one positive. Two negatives are attacking on one positive. Is it clear? Then what is the thing that is happening here? Then CH2 minus C double bonded O O R is formed here. CH2 minus C O O R is formed. Let me complete the mechanism. Then I will ask your opinions. Clear? Now let us go to the second step of the mechanism. So CH2 minus C O O R, this is formed. Now what happened? Let us take the ketone. It is a carbonyl. Followed everyone. So pi bond will shift here. Carbon gets positive charge. This negative attacks on this positive. Negative attacks on the positive. Followed. Then here, what is the thing that is going to form them? Now, R1CO minus. Then this will be R2. Then here, CH2COOR is formed here. Clear? Then this on hydrolysis, okay, this on hydrolysis O minus ions will take H plus ions. So R1 C R2, then here we will get the OH. Clear? OH. Then after CH2 C O O R. Okay, now here actually I want to write at one place only, but if I write at one place some people can't understand. Now here one more thing I want to explain. Now you see this ester is there na, ester also undergo hydrolysis. We studied na ester hydrolysis. So ester also undergo hydrolysis. Followed. So when ester undergo hydrolysis, then what happened? Okay, let me explain like this. Now you see I shown yesterday also, when ester undergo hydrolysis, then add OH here, H here. Okay, then what is the thing that is going to form here when ester undergo hydrolysis? R1 C R2, then here OH, and here CH2, then here COOH. Followed? Okay, plus ROH is formed, that is a byproduct here, ROH. Now in this product, once you see, now everyone, this is the acid. Okay, acid bonded carbon alpha, this is the beta carbon. So this is the beta hydroxy acid, beta hydroxy acid, this is only for your information, beta hydroxy acid. Clear? Here CH2 is there na, can I write this CH2 like this? Once you see now, everyone know CH2, in this way I am writing CH2. Okay, in our equation heating also there, heating. So in heating what happened? H2O liberates out. In acidic medium H2O liberates out like this. I think you know dehydration happens in acidic medium. So when H2O liberates, then finally we will get a pi bond. So what is the final product that I am writing here? Final product is R1 C R2 double bonded CH COOH. Okay, so this is the alpha carbon, this is the beta carbon, between them unsaturation is there. So alpha beta unsaturated acid. Alpha, beta, unsaturated acid is formed. This is the mechanism of the Reformatsky reaction. Okay, this is the mechanism of the Reformatsky reaction. So, I hope you guys understood the mechanism. Please tell me, are you able to understand the mechanism clearly, everyone? Followed everyone, Reformat's mechanism? Reformat's mechanism understood everyone? Okay. Now let us do some questions on Reformatsky reaction. Followed. So now Reformatsky mechanism here. Clear. So now I want to give some questions on Reformatsky. So now first question, see clearly, everyone. Now I am taking here benzaldehyde. Okay, sorry, I made a mistake here. Alpha bromoester, right? Okay, alpha bromoester. So now same reagents here, zinc. Okay, next, acidic hydrolysis followed by heating. What is the product form? Come on, try this question. One of the previous JEE advanced question. This one. With same mechanism, try this one, everyone. There is no trick for this reaction. For everything, trick will not be there. Wherever it is there, I will explain. I will be explaining. Come on, come on. Please respond. Did you got the answer? One student send the response. Everyone, please respond. What happened to others? Some 4 or 5 students send the answer. Others also please respond. Okay, right, very good. What is the name of that acid, you know? The acid, whatever the answer you got, that is no doubt correct. What is the name of that acid? Many times I told already, name of that acid. Anyone can name it? Yes, very good. Cinnamic acid. That acid is the cinnamic acid. Clear, everyone? Cinnamic acid is the product form. Followed. I think no need to do exam, no need to solve this question. Most of you got the correct answer. Answer is the cinnamic acid. Followed one more question. Chalo, we will do one more question now. So this is the first question. Now, second one. Okay. So second one I am writing here. ETO, C double bonded O. Next. CH, BR, then after CH2, this is the compound given, okay? So same again, this when treated with zinc, followed by acidic hydrolysis, followed by heating, what is the product formed? What is the product formed here? Okay, so this question let me solve. Now, try to understand here. Okay, so I want to solve directly. Bromine bonded carbon will get negative charge. Here, pi bond will shift here. This carbon will get the positive charge. Clear? This negative attacks on this positive. So let us do the numbering. This is the first carbon, second one, third carbon, 4, 5, and this is the sixth carbon. Clear? So we will get here six-membered ring. So for the sixth carbon we are having COOET. Clear? Let me number so that it will be clear to you. So this is the first carbon, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one. For the sixth carbon I want to write directly, okay? O minus is there. O minus will take extra ions, then you will get OH. Hope it is clear. Now this on hydrolysis, okay, this on hydrolysis, so ester undergo hydrolysis and forms what? Acid. Here OH is there, and for this carbon one hydrogen is also there. So this on heating loses the water molecule, okay? So this on heating loses the water molecule. Then finally we will get the pi bond inside the ring. Clear? Pi bond inside the ring. This is the answer. Hope you are able to understand this one. Let me see. Is it clear, everyone? Got the answer or not for this question? Yes, okay. Still one more question is there from the previous advance. Let us solve that also. Then we'll change the reaction. Okay, now the next one, next question. This is the compound given. Okay, so this one is reacting with three reagents. Okay, what are the three? Okay, formaldehyde, acidic hydrolysis, followed by heating. What is the product formed? What is the product formed here? So I want you to try this one. Okay, let me solve this one. I think you might have got the answer, but anyway, see the solution here. So I want to put some direct steps here. Now this is COOPH. After losing the bromine, then that carbon will get the negative charge. Hope it is clear, everyone. Followed. Now here, let me take the formaldehyde. This is formaldehyde. Clear. So pi bond will shift here. This carbon get the positive charge. Now what happened? This negative attacks on this positive. Okay. So as a result, what is the thing that is going to come here? Okay, then here CH2O minus when treated with H plus of water, then here you will get COOPH. Clear? Then here CH2OH. Followed. Now this on acidic hydrolysis, esters on hydrolysis, okay, gives what? Acid COOH and CH2OH. Clear? Now see clearly, everyone. Now so functional group bonded carbon alpha carbon. Clear? And this is the beta carbon, but you see for alpha carbon there is no hydrogen. Okay, as I told you, on heating water molecule should be eliminated. On heating water molecule will be eliminated from alpha carbon, but on alpha carbon already alpha carbon got four bonds. There is no hydrogen that is to be eliminated, therefore further no reaction. Okay, and this is the final product. Remember, on alpha carbon there is no hydrogen to be removed, so further no reaction will happen. Reaction stops here only. I hope it is clear to everyone. Everyone, is it clear? We are cyclohexane. I don't know how cyclohexane I got. You got? I didn't understand also. Who is this? Lakshman Ram. Okay, come on, tell me. Still. Any for Matsky reaction? Once again, explain why no reaction. Alpha carbon is not having any hydrogen to be removed. Further reaction is not possible. Come on, please respond. What happened? Very few. Clear? Right. Let us go to the next reaction then. Okay, this is about the Reformatsky reaction. Okay, now in the named reactions, now the next one. Now, Novengel reaction. Novengel reaction. Okay, in past 2 years, in past 5 years papers, 2 times we got the question from Novengel reaction. Let me write clearly this one. This is N. Novengel's reaction. Okay, so first of all, let me explain. Very simple. Okay, but very important one. 2 times we got the question from past 5 years. So it is the condensation between. It is the condensation between AMG. I told in the last class also active methylene group. Okay. With any carbonyl. Carbonyl means aldehyde or ketone, anything. Okay, it is the condensation between AMG with any carbonyl. AMG with any carbonyl. So let me show the mechanism. Okay, then the product, then its application also. Clear? So now see clearly. CH2 COO ET twice. Okay, so here this CH2 is there now. See clearly, this is AMG active methylene group because it is surrounded by 2 -M groups. 2 esters are there now. Followed everyone. So this is the -M group, that is the AMG. So now that is reacting with what? Pure carbonyl. You take any aldehyde or ketone. Okay, in presence of a base like pyridine. In presence of a base like pyridine. Okay, what is the product form? What is the product form, dear? Followed? So now we are going to see the mechanism. Very simple mechanism of Novengel reaction. Okay, so first of all, CH2, okay, let me rub this negative charge, sorry. Now, CH2, COO, ET twice. Clear? So, what happened here? First of all, let me take pyridine. I think you know pyridine is a base. Followed? So what happened now? Pyridine base na. So base will remove hydrogen, one hydrogen from here. Base will remove one hydrogen from here, one hydrogen from AMG. It is active methylene. That means it will give H+ very easily. Clear? So when base removes one hydrogen, then you will get the negative charge here. Then COOET twice is as it is. Okay, now let me take the pure carbonyl R1, see double bonded OR2. Okay, so pi bond will shift here. This carbon gets the negative charge, not positive charge, sorry. Now negative charge attacks on this positive charge. Did you notice? All these reactions are of same type almost. Okay, almost same type. Not much difference is there. Okay, now what is the product that we are getting here? R1CR2, then here O minus, and here CHCOOET twice. Clear? So now when you go H+ to the O minus, so it will convert into R1CR2, then here OH, and here CH, then here COOET twice. Clear? Okay, now this on hydrolysis. Remember, same previous steps only. In the previous mechanism, reformat mechanism, okay, there also we did hydrolysis. Here also the same thing again. So here two esters are there, try to understand. Okay, so here you see two esters are there. So two esters undergo hydrolysis and forms what? Acid. So R1 CR2, then here OH, and here CH, COOH, COOH. Clear? Now this on heating, many times I told you gem dicarboxylic acids on heating liberates CO2. Gem dicarboxylic acids on heating liberates CO2. Clear? Now what is the thing left over? Then R1 CR2, then here OH. Clear? Then what is left over here? CH2. Okay, CH2 in this way I am writing, then COOH. COOH. Clear? Now finally this on heating, what happened? Water molecule eliminates out. Finally water molecule eliminates out. Okay, then what is the final product formed here? R1 CR2, double bonded CH COOH, alpha beta unsaturated acid. Alpha beta unsaturated acid. Even in the previous case also, in the reformat also we got same alpha beta unsaturated acid only. So these reactions are almost one and same, not much difference is there. Hope you are able to understand. Please copy quickly. Come on, come on. Some students are sending the message, wait for some time. If you complete quickly, then we can do some questions on this reaction. Okay, now tell me. Is clear everyone? Novengel reaction mechanism is clear or not? What happened? Followed? Okay, as I told you, in last 5 years papers we got two questions. Who is the student who is asking how CO2 liberates? Very good. From 12F Vishwa KNMS, how CO2 liberates, sir? That means you didn't attend the previous classes. Gem dicarboxylic acids always liberate 1 mole of CO2. Others, please respond quickly. Is the mechanism clear, everyone? What happened? Girls and boys, clear? And I told you, we got two questions from the past 5 years. Okay, so we are going to do the two questions, and you have to do that one now. Come on, write down. I want you to do the questions now. So now, first question. What is the product formed here? What is the product formed? I hope you wrote the question. Yes, very good. Many students are giving the answer, cinnamic acid. Actually, once we got the question like this in multiple correct answer, which of the following produces cinnamic acid? Novengel reaction as well as Reformatsky reaction. I hope you understood the question, everyone. Novengel reaction, Reformatsky reaction, both the cases, we got the cinnamic acid only. Is it clear, everyone? Followed Novengel as well as Reformatsky. In both the cases, we can prepare cinnamic acid. Yes, most of the students wrote the answer. No need to solve the question. Okay. So let us take one more question on this reaction. Now, one more question here. Write down. So solve this one. Quickly. Okay, hope you are doing this question. Okay. Is it clear? What happened? No response. Malonic acid, no.
20, yeah. 210.
Malonic acid is not the answer. Okay, let me solve this question. If I miss the question, you people are not able to solve. Come on, let me solve this question. Okay, so Here only I want to discuss. Pyridine is the base. Clear? So pyridine will remove H plus from here because it is acid. Similarly, pyridine will remove H plus from the AMG also. Pyridine will remove H plus from the acid. Pyridine will remove H plus from the AMG also. Okay, at a time. So now, what is left over that we are going to see from AMG? Okay, let me write clearly. Now, from AMG, this is left over. Followed from starting one, acid is removed now. So C double bonded O, O minus left over. Then one is the aldehyde. Clear? Now what happened? Pi bond will shift towards oxygen. Carbon get positive. Now this attacks on this one. Followed. Then what happened here? COO minus as it is. Okay. Then this one CH O minus. Okay. Then here CH. Okay. CN. Clear? Now this on hydrolysis. Try to understand. COO minus will gain H plus from water. Okay. Then here CH. Then O minus also will gain H plus from water. Then CH. I think you know. Cyanides on hydrolysis gives acids. Cyanides on hydrolysis will give acids. So again, this is the gem dicarboxylic acid. Gem dicarboxylic acid will liberate one mole of CO2. Gem dicarboxylic acids always liberate one mole of CO2. Then what is left over? COOH. Okay. Now CH. Here OH. Then here CH2. COOH. Come on, please copy quickly. Okay, now which on heating loses the water molecule? Clear? Now, here, once you see everyone know, try to understand my concept here, everyone know. So here you see now, functional group bonded carbon is alpha carbon. Is it clear? Now here also, functional group is there na? Functional group bonded carbon, alpha carbon. Clear everyone? So what happened now? Here we have to take any one COOH. Okay, let me explain clearly here. Now, once you see now everyone know. Here, let me rub this one. I want to explain somewhere clearly. Afterwards, you write. Now, so here you see now, this is the functional group here. Functional group bonded carbon is alpha carbon. Okay. So, from alpha carbon, remove the hydrogen. Clear? From beta carbon, remove the OH. Then what happened? We are going to see that one. Okay. Then what happened? What is the thing that is forming here? COOH. Then CH, okay. Then you'll get the double bonded CH, COOH. Clear? This is alpha carbon, this is beta carbon. Okay, you can ask me now. Now let me change this. I want to rub this pink color. Once you see everyone, afterwards you write. Okay, now let me rub this one. Now, once you see everyone, try to understand my concept here. Okay, This is the functional group now. Okay. Afterwards, we write functional group bonded carbon alpha carbon. Now, for alpha carbon, hydroxy is bonded using. Okay. Now, with respect to this one. Okay. This is beta carbon. Am I right? So, with respect to this one, this is alpha carbon. Remember one important point. Beta hydroxy acids require less heating than alpha hydroxy acids. I will write that point here. Okay, so I am writing here. Beta hydroxy acids, okay, require less heating. Less heating than alpha hydroxy acids. What is the reason that you are going to the physical chemistry part? But just remember here, clear everyone? Beta hydroxy acids require less heating than alpha hydroxy acids. That is the reason why. Okay, now listen here, everyone. Now try to understand. So this is the alpha carbon. I removed hydrogen from beta carbon. I removed OH. Then this is the final product formed here. Beta hydroxy acids require less heating than alpha hydroxy acids. Okay. Now this is not completed. Remember everyone. This exists in geometry. I mean, whatever the acid I got here, okay, now it will exhibit the geometrical isomerism. It will exhibit the geometrical isomerism. C double bonded C, okay. I will write both the hydrogen same side. Next, both the COOH group same side. Clear? This is one possibility. Next, let me write two hydrogens both the sides. Opposite side. Now here, this one. Clear? So this is the trans isomer and this is the cis isomer, and I think you know trans isomer is the stable isomer, therefore it is the major and this is the minor. I think you know they are maleic and fumaric acids. Okay, trans isomer is what? Fumaric acid. Fumaric acid. Cis isomer is what? Maleic acid. Clear? Cis isomer is the maleic acid. Trans isomer is the fumaric acid. This is the mechanism of this one. And once again, I am telling everyone, beta hydroxy acids always require less heating than alpha hydroxy acids. Completed. So tell me, any doubts to anyone in this one? Any doubts to any students here? One student, Harini from KNMS. How did CN become COOH? Cyanides on hydrolysis gives always acids. Yes, tell me again. Any doubts to anyone? Completed. At the end, I will show all the slides. Okay. Now, then after we are going to see. Okay. Next one, that is reduction. All the named reactions completed in this lesson. Now, simple reactions are left over. Reduction. Clear everyone? Now, in case of the reduction, what happened here? I will take the carboxylic acid or COOH. Okay, so when carboxylic acid is reduced with strong reducing agent like lithium aluminium hydride followed by acidic hydrolysis, then you will get your primary alcohol. You will get primary alcohol. Completed. Okay, now for example, let me take here CH3COOH. When undergo reduction with lithium aluminium hydride, okay, then what is the thing that is formed here? CH3CH2OH ethanol is formed, primary alcohol. Finished, very simple reaction. Next one. All important reactions are completed, but still one left over. Okay, so reaction with PCl3, PCl5, and SOCl2, thionyl chloride. Many times we had seen this reaction. PCl3, PCl5, and SOCl2. Okay, so what happened? Carboxylic acid when treated with PCl3. Okay, so 3 moles I have to take here. Then what I will get here? 3 moles of RCOCl acid chloride plus byproduct is what? Phosphorus acid. Similarly, with PCl5, then RCOOH when treated with PCl5, then here also we will get the same product, acid chloride plus COCl3. Plus HCl. These reactions many times we did. That is why I am not explaining that much in depth here. Next is the thionyl chloride, RCOOH, when treated with SOCl2. Okay. Here also again same thing we will get, acid chloride plus SO2 plus HCl. So once you see, in all the cases, same product, RCOCl only. Main product is RCOCl in all the cases. Clear? In this lesson, still 2-3 reactions are there. By that, acids will be completed, then amines will be left over. Okay, so tomorrow I am going to complete acids, and tomorrow itself I am going to start the amines, the last lesson. Amines is the last lesson. Followed, so many students are asking slides, to show the slides. I think they are interested only in slides only. From that time onwards they are asking slides only, okay. Come on. Starting onwards, I am showing the slides. See clearly. Okay, then next one. Then after, next one. Okay, then here I solve this question, you see. Then one more question I solved here. Next, Novengel reaction. So this is the mechanism of Novengel reaction. And these are some questions on Novengel reaction. Okay. Then reduction. Then after reaction with PCl3, PCl5 and SOCl2. Followed everyone? Right. So we will meet in the tomorrow's class. Clear?